Hi everyone, welcome back to Dalaran Models. In this video I'm going to be doing a brief demonstration of making the Top Studio clutch, and this one's for the RC211V model. So this is what you get in the kit. You just get three photo etch frets. One of them, as you can see, is copper, and then you've got the brass one there, and then what looks like a steel or an aluminium one there. And then you get a resin piece for the top part, which I've already painted that up. So what we'll do, we'll start by opening the bag and getting these photo etch pieces out. So you can see there a little bit closer what you've got. So you've got this piece here, which makes up the basket, and then the top pieces for that, and then that piece there will be the actual very top of it. And then you've got two different pieces on here, one that's perfectly round and one that's got a bit of a shape to it, which is what makes up the actual clutch assembly itself, with the clutch plates and the friction plates. So if I can get the plastic off. Which is easier said than done in this case, normally a bit easier than that. Seem to be struggling today for some reason. There we go. Try and keep it as flat as you can. You don't want to risk unnecessarily bending them or anything. So these are actually all attached, so I'm just going to nip round quickly on all of them and separate them. So what I'll do, rather than sitting here with you watching me on camera doing this, I'll just cut off and then I'll come back when they're all separated. Right, I've got all them separated, as you can see now. So I've got parts number two there and parts number one there. So we actually only need five of each, but I've cut them all off so that I've got them in case I need them. So next bit is to take the actual part off that makes the bracket, and then all of these want very carefully bending over so that they're all upright, like that. So I'm not doing them all the way at the moment, I'm just getting them to the rough shape, and I'll go around and make sure they're all where they need to be once they've got started. So that's the basket which all plates go into. So the next bit to do is to start stacking these up. So basically get the ring and drop that inside, and then you get one of these, and then you get the teeth so that they fit inside of each of the baskets. So there's five each of these, so that's the first one. Then that's the second one. And third one. So as far as fiddling this goes, as you can see, they're not too bad. That's the fourth one. this will be the last one. That sits in properly. So then you can see there how it's all built up. And then the next piece that goes on there will be this one here. Which I'm just going to run round with the file. I did that on the friction plate parts off camera while sorting those out. So that's going to go on there, and then I'll get this one ready as well. Feels like it. It's not. That's okay. So, I want to get a bit of glue and a cocktail stick. Right. So, there's my glue ready. Going to do is carefully just run around a couple of points on this. Just to drop that on. And this is where it gets a little bit more fiddly, because all of the holes in that need to go over the vertical bits that you just bent up on the actual basket. But again, if you've got them bent up correctly in the right positions, it should be fairly straightforward, like so. And then put some glue around here. Got this last photo piece for this that goes on top there, and again same again through those holes, so you can see there how it's made up. And then the last piece for that, when I find where to put it, is the bit that I painted earlier, which just sits on there. And then there's one photo etch plate that will sit on top of that. So, right. Just try to think. If I do this the other way, it says if I put this in a Dremel or something like that with the photo etch plate on it, and then it'll polish up. So I'll go and do that off camera, and then I'll come back. Right, so there you go. After spinning it on the rotary tool, you can see that it's got a shine to it now, and that sort of effect from the sandpaper to give it the I don't know what you'd call it, but yeah, the circles. So the last bit to do now is just to glue that on. So again, a bit of super glue just around there. Put that in there. And then the final touch is just this centerpiece. See how it sits first of all. Just like that. So, obviously that glue's still a little bit wet. So So what I'll do is I'll get a cocktail stick, which I'll just wet, just to make it a bit easier to pick it up. And then get the other end of the one in the super glue and just put a little dot in the centre of there, just to place this. Just like that. So that's the Top Studio clutch assembled. So as you can see, if I go and get the, that's the plastic part that comes with it, with the kit, and then that's the replacement detailer part in the, that comes with the fork set, or in my case this was in the kit as well, but you can see, if it focuses, the difference in quality between the two and what you're actually getting for your money. So that is well worth the extra money, in my view, for the extra detail that you get and the overall look of the bike once it's all finished. So hope you enjoyed it, and thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.